Good afternoon, dear colleagues from Bolivia. My name is Vadim Marshall. I'm professor of the Economic School of the Moscow State University, named by Michael Lomonosov. For several months, my new textbook on the history of Vladivostok, which I am now showing to you, was published by Springer Publishing House. Greetings from Russia and from Moscow to all colleagues and students of the Universidad Autónoma Juan Misael Saracho and to the academic community in Bolivia, the management learners in Bolivia. And I want to especially thank the professor of management, Mr. Robert Daniel Sisena Misael, for the opportunity to give you a short presentation on the results of my research on management and the history of management. So, I know that you are studying managerial ideas, you are studying management, and in this regard I would like to share with you the results of my investigation or research in management and in history of management thought, which means history of management ideas, concepts, theories. But I will start with the definition of the term management, which I introduced in my latest monography on the history of management thought. By management, I mean two types of activities, universal human activity and professional activity. Management as a universal human activity is the impact of one person, which is called subject of impact, on another person, they say the object of impact. And as a result of this impact, the object changed his behavior. I am absolutely sure that you remember many, many examples of such impact from your childhood. For instance, a child who is with his parents in a shopping center begins to impact his parents with his whims and requests to buy him toy, sometimes sport car like Mercedes. And parents fulfill the child's wish. They change their own behavior and their own plans. For instance, if they came to the mall to buy new furniture for the new apartment, and they execute the child's command, they buy the required toy. The most important thing in such universal management impact is that parents change their behavior. They fulfill the requirements of decision their child, but at the same time, the child as a subject of impact is not responsible for the result of this decision. Management as professional activity, absolutely opposite, is also an impact subject and on object, which also change the behavior on the object, but which, in addition to the universal human activity, has specific three characteristics. It is systematic impact, eligible impact, and responsible impact. I think the meaning of each characteristic is clear, but I would like to highlight the essential characteristics of management. As a professional activity, it is a professional and responsible impact. I assert that the manager and only the manager bears responsibility for his management decisions. The subject of impact may be individual, like president of country or owner of family business or owner of the football club, and also it may be a group of people, the United Nations or International Olympic Committee. In the next few minutes, I will talk about the management just as about the professional activity. It is absolutely obvious that professional management activity has a history of many, many thousand years, beginning from ancient origins to the present day. Look at the title of my textbook on history of management thought. During this time, many efficient and effective ideas have been accumulated with the professional impact, when the subjects of management were acted by statesmen or government bodies or religious companies or public or private companies. And as objects of impact, there were individuals, groups of people, or social organizations. Precisely because management professional activity has many thousand years of history, I myself study such managerial ideas and the possibilities of their practical application in management of modern public and private companies, any size, of all sizes, in different regions of the world, in different sectors of the economy, like oil industry or education or sport. I'm looking for and have been researching the best managerial ideas and concepts in history of management for over 40 years. And I challenge you to seek these ideas, to find them, to study them, and research such managerial ideas. Trust me, this is not only cognitive activity, but also a scientific and practical activity in a part that makes me, and hopefully will make you, seek answers to the questions. Why this or that manager change his impact on his organization or management or company? In other words, what kind of factors and reasons made him change his decision? These factors are often of external business environment of companies, such as political, economic, sociological, legal, technological factors, as well as internal factors of companies characterizing the competitiveness of the company, the behavior and the competences of its employees, the employee evaluation system, etc. It is sure possible that the factors of success in management that you will identify in this study of historical materials will be used by you in future. Likewise, the factors of failure will be at least considered by you in decision-making managerial process in present and future life as managers of companies. On top of that, the constant search for answers to the questions why and what has changed and is changing in the management of organizations will help you improve the level of your management competences, both as scientists and as practitioners. I would like to conclude my speech with two statements about actual problems of modern management. The first is the uncertainty and unpredictability of the future, or black swan, as Nassim Taleb says. The second, almost as a result of the first statement, is an insufficient competence of managers in taking responsible management decisions related to the future. I should say that both problems are eternal, which once again emphasizes the importance of studying cases of our managerial past to successfully solve managerial problems in our present and future. In other words, to know what will happen, you need to know what already happened in the past. And a few words in conclusion. I believe that management has always existed. Management exists, and management will always exist in the future. And trust me again, the world needs you. The world needs competent managers. That's why I urge you to advance your level of professional competences and wish you good luck in your future management activities. Thank you.